Morning, class 9. Today we are going to start with the discussion of the chapter Happy Prince, right? So what we have read about Happy Prince? Who? Stand up, please.
The story is about kindness and selflessness. One must be selfless and the happy prince was
very good.
But when he died, his statue was made and he could see all the history and history of the country. He was very moved and was weeping. He could not do anything. He was covered with spires, rubies, golden sheep. But after all, being a statue, he could not move. Once an Egypt landed the for sheep, it was moving towards Egypt. And the prince requested her to help him eliminate the mystery of his kingdom.
Yes.
Golden
sheets to the poor, and ultimately, when at the last God sent his angels to find the two most beautiful things on earth. So, this room, what did the angels find? And the dead swallow. Good, very good. So, what did they find? The angels found the leaden heart of the happy prince as well as the dead body of the swallow. That were the two most beautiful things. And finally, what happened? The God allowed the happy prince that he will always stay in heaven and will praise him forever. And moreover, after that, this dead swallow shall always sing in the garden of heaven. Okay. So ultimately, this chapter is delivering us the values of selfless love, to be empathetic towards others, to have feeling behavior towards the sufferings of others. If we don't have, even God would not allow us to, God would never allow us to be a part of him even after death. So one should have a soft corner towards the feelings of others. So this we have read through this chapter. Okay, so let us discuss the question answers of this chapter. First of all, the question number one is, why do the courtiers call the prince the happy prince? This we have discussed yesterday, first one. Okay. Why does the happy prince send a ruby for the seamstress? And what does the swallow usually do in the seamstress house? Okay, Lavlina.
The condition was very poor. Her face was thin and worn, and she had coarse red hands or pricked by the needle.
Condition was very miserable. So why does Happy Prince send a rupee for the seamstress, for the poor condition as well as the pitiable condition of the seamstress? As what the seamstress was doing, seamstress son, who was lying on the bed, he was suffering from acute fever and he was asking for oranges, but she had nothing to give him except river water. And the seamstress was not able to pay any attention towards her son who was suffering from fever. And why? But why she was not able to pay any attention towards her son? Because she was embroidering the flowers on the satin gowns of the queen's maids of honor, which they are intending or which they have to wear during the ball or the court ball dance. Okay, she was busy to fulfill the order in the stipulated or in the targeted time. So this is the reason why she was not able to pay any attention towards her child. And moreover, when the happy prince saw this miserable condition of the seamstress as well as her son, he thought that they should be helped out. So he had nothing except to give the ruby, which was affixed on the sword hilt. So he has told the swallow to take out that ruby out of the sword hilt and give it to the seamstress. Okay. And what does the swallow do in the seamstress house? So you know. Okay. Yes, Eva, stand up. Very good. Okay, yes. So the swallow, in order to listen the careful advice of Happy Prince, he took the ruby out of the sword hit and flew towards the seamstress house. So when he has gone to the seamstress house, so there you can say there he has entered through the window which was opened into the house, and the seamstress was asleep as she was tired of doing the work. Okay, she has the swallow has also seen the young boy lying on the bed. He was tossing from one side of the bed towards other because he was suffering from fever. So the swallow made a round around the bed of the boy and fanning her or fluttering the wings. This made the boy feel little bit relieved as well as cool. And then afterwards, what he has done, he has dropped the red rupee on the side of the thimble. And both these things were placed on the table and flew away back. This was the great act of, you can say, help that was performed by the swallow also, who was a part of in this good act with that of the Happy Prince. So Panika, next answer you will give. Third is, for whom does the Prince send the sapphires and why? Yes, Panika, speak out.
Yes, ma'am. The prince sent the two sapphires of his eyes, one for the young writer, for the match girl. Mm-hmm. And the young writer was trying to finish a play for the director of the theater, but he was too cold to write anymore. There was no fire in the grate and hunger had made him faint. So the Happy Prince sent one of the sapphire of his eyes to him so that he could sell it to the jeweler and buy firewood and finish his play. Mm-hmm. And he sent another sapphire for the match girl because the match girl's matches fell in the gutter and got spoiled. She was crying as her father would beat her for this mistake. So the Happy Prince sent the other sapphire to her so that she would not get beaten up when her father sees the gem she has got.
Yes, so let us write down. Okay, let us read the story. So what does the prince send the sapphires to? The two sapphires which were making the eyes of the Happy Prince, they were sent one to the playwright and another to that of the match girl who was standing in the square of the city. Square, you understand now? Okay. So the Happy Prince has seen the poor as well as pitiable condition of the playwright who was sitting in the garret without any fire. It was too cold for him to finish his play. And they were also placed withered violets on the side of the table, which also shows his poor condition. So the Happy Prince felt that he did not have any money to kindle the wood in order to light some fire. So the Happy Prince felt the need of money, and the Happy Prince felt that the playwright has the need of money, and what he did, he has told the swallow to take out one sapphire and give it to the playwright so that he could purchase wood and would light the fire, okay, and would finish his play as he was writing a play for the director of theaters, right? So, but when the prince told the swallow to pluck the other eye, the swallow was not at all ready. Okay, the swallow was reluctant to pluck the other eye of the Happy Prince because that would make the Happy Prince blind. He would not be able to see the world around him while standing on the tall column. So what the swallow did, but the Happy Prince insisted the swallow to pluck another sapphire and give it to the match girl who was standing in the square, okay, public square she was standing. And then what happened, she was selling the matches, and her matches, they had been spoiled because they have fallen into the gutter, they were dampened, okay, and she was afraid that she would be severely beaten by her father for not bringing any money at home. So what she thought, she was worried by these, her thoughts were full of worry while standing in the square. And when the swallow came with another sapphire and dropped onto her empty palm, she was amazed to see that shining piece of glass, but she did not know the worth of that shining piece of glass, which was actually a sapphire. So what happened after that? Then she has taken that shining piece of glass towards her father, who came to know that it is a precious stone, and all their miseries as well as worries have vanished, and they have come out of their poor condition. Right? So this is how Swallow has given. So next is, what does the swallow see when it flies over the city? Yes, Ramnik.
When the swallow was flying over the city, it saw the rich making merry and the beggars sitting at the gates of the rich man's
house. Very good.
It flew into dark lanes and saw the white faces of starving children under the archway of a bridge. Saw two little boys lying in each other's arms, trying to keep themselves warm. They were extremely hungry. The swallow went back and told the prince.
Yes. So what happened that when the swallow was flying over the city, or first of all, you can also write down that the happy prince who has lost both of his eyes, now he also wanted to see the world, and he was looking at the world, or he was having the, you can say, idea of the world with the eyes of swallow. So he told the swallow to fly around the city and give him the true picture of the people of his city. So what the swallow did, the swallow has flown over the city and has come to notice that rich people are busy in merrymaking, and the poor people, they are sitting at their gates waiting for alms and for spare food. Okay, and moreover, under the arch bridge, the swallow had also seen that two boys, they were sitting, clinging their arms together in order to keep themselves warm. They were barefoot and they did not have any clothes to protect themselves from cold weather. And the watchman had come and have drove them away also, that they are not allowed to sit under this arch bridge. Okay. So the swallow has presented the true picture of the suffering of the people to the happy prince. And then happy prince, who has come to know the actual condition or the misery of the people, has told the swallow to give each sheet of gold that was covering his body so that these people can sell this gold and get money. Okay. As he knew that when he was alive, he knew that it was only money that make the people happy, or it was gold that make people happy. Right? This answer is clear. Okay. Next is, why did the swallow not leave the prince and go to Egypt? Yes. Okay. Yes. Ash, Preet, Hanji. So absolutely right what you have said is, why did the swallow not leave the happy prince? Because swallow's heart is also full of emotion. She also had a golden heart. She had love for the prince. Yes, she was also in love. Okay, we can say, but that love is not like, you can say, it is the love that exists between two different persons like a boy and girl. It was the love of affection. Okay, there are many forms of love which exist. Okay, you can say that. We can't say that it was that kind of love, because the swallow, she felt she was a great admirer of the golden heart of the happy prince. Okay, she knew that happy prince is a person full of, you can say, goodness for others. So the swallow has stayed there, because even the swallow was full of emotions. He also did not want to leave the happy prince. Okay, why he did not want to leave the happy prince? Because for the first time, when the swallow had helped the seamstress, after coming back, the swallow has shared his feeling to the happy prince that he is also feeling content as well as warmth. And the happy prince has told him that this is the warmth as well as the satisfaction that comes out of helping others. So it means that when you do good to others, you will have the feeling of contentment. Okay, it means that you find inner peace. So this inner peace is sought by that of swallow also. Okay, although the weather was not, you can say, the weather was not allowing him to stay there with the happy prince, because it was cold weather, which was not at all favorable. And moreover, the swallow was being waited for in Egypt by his friends. Right? So what happened? The swallow as he has fell in love with the good deeds as well as the great heart of Happy Prince, who was full of selfless love, and it was full of, you can say, kindness, generosity towards the feelings of others. He was a, you can say, feeling attitude towards others, empathetic feeling towards others. So this is the reason why Sweller did not want to leave the Happy Prince. And moreover, apart from it, the Swallow has also understood as well as sensitized the need of eyes for Happy Prince, as the Happy Prince has given both of his eyes to one to the playwright and another to that of the match girl. So the Swallow has also come to know that now Happy Prince has turned out to be blind, and he would not be able to see the world around. So what happened? So he decided, actually it is written he. Okay, so he decided to stay with the Happy Prince in order to be his eyes. So this is love as well as, you can say, understanding of feelings between both of them that made him to stay there, right? Okay. Next is, what are the precious things mentioned in the story and why are they precious? What are the precious things mentioned in the story? Only these 4 or 5 girls are raising up hands. From the boys, yes, who will give the answer? Yes, Dia, what are the precious things?
The two precious things mentioned here are the better part of the Prince and the Red Zone.
Yes. Sit down, please. So finally, actually, this chapter also delivers the message. It is not the money that is always precious, but the actual heart as well as the person full of feelings, they are the actual treasure. Okay, so the writer has very well explained the treasurable things at the, on the earth. When and finally, when the Swallow was dead, then the Happy Prince was also taken out of its or brought down from its tall column, and his heart and his body was melted in the furnace, but his leaden heart, which was not able to melt in the furnace, was thrown on a heap of trash. So at that moment, the God has told his two angels, one of his angels, to bring the two most precious things from earth. And what they have found, they searched the entire earth and they found the leaden heart of Happy Prince and the dead body of the Swallow. For these are full of kindness, generosity, selfless love towards others. They have sacrificed their lives. They have given everything of themselves in order to help others, to let others come out of misery. That is the actuality of life, that the persons who are full of emotions for others, they are actually the helping hands for others. They are always welcomed and appreciated in the house of God. Okay, so this is the reason why they have been brought. So the little Swallow says, it is curious, but I feel quite warm now, although it is so cold. Have you ever had such a feeling? Sometimes you had this kind of feeling when you feel, yes, of course, we are human beings. When we help somebody else out of, you can say, out of any selfish motive, then we feel this, then we have this kind of feeling that you can say that when you help somebody going out of the way, okay, you help somebody by sacrificing your own life or by sacrificing your own needs. At the end of the day, when you just think for a while upon the complete act or the complete routine, then you have this kind of feeling, yes, this I have done positive today. This is the right thing that I have done today. At that moment, your heart is filled of, you can say, strange kind of happiness, which is inexplicable in words. You can't explain that kind of happiness in words. Okay, but at the other moment, when human beings, they turn out to be so senseless, when they have turned out to be stone towards the feelings of others, at that time when they hurt others, then what they try to justify their acts. Usne mere saath aisa kiya, tabhi maine aisa kiya. But ultimately, if he has done wrong, it is not necessary that you will also do wrong with that person. It is not necessary. Okay, but you know that wrong things can be corrected by doing the right things also. If someone is wrong, it is not necessary that you will do double wrong in order to make him right. Okay, sometimes your one act of goodness can change the person's attitude, because every person, there is always innate goodness hidden in every human being. Okay, innate goodness, you can say that is the goodness at heart. Every human being, he is always having this feeling of, you can say, goodness, which is always hidden. Although the human being is trying to do lot of bad things towards others, lot of he can be of annoying nature, or he will be trying to hurt the feelings of others just for out of his only selfish motive. But at one point, so he will always feel, yes, this is wrong that I'm doing. Okay. So I think that if all the human beings will have this kind of feeling to respect the feelings of others, then I don't think so there would be any kind of, you can say, disputes on this earth to left. Okay. So this kind of feeling everyone can have at one or the other time. Right. So it is not, you can say, it is not unnatural, but it is natural one. Okay. That comes out of your heart only. So the next is Selfish Giant. Who has written The Selfish Giant by Oscar Wilde? Have you read this story? You must be knowing this story when I'll narrate you. You know what is Selfish Giant? You must have read it in other language also. Oscar Wilde is a writer who is writing, you can say, stories with supernatural element. For example, he won, that is, in Plus One, there is a novel, The Canterville Ghosts. Okay, so in that also, it was the story of a ghost. In the starting, you will see, it is very interesting one, that in the starting, this ghost was a figure of terror. Okay, but at the end, it has emerged out to be a figure of pity. So what happened that in a house, which was haunted for many years, nobody was purchasing that house. You must have read that. Okay, so you must be knowing that nobody was purchasing that house. So what happened? Ultimately, a family purchased that house. And everyone in the family was afraid of the ghost. The ghost has tried number of ways to terrorize the people in the family, but nobody got. So the ghost, he was in grace, you can say anxiety. He was feeling that koi mere se dar hi nahi raha hai. At the end, what happened when he was in a very sad mood? And then what happened? The girl of the house, who was very soft at heart, she felt pity for the ghost, and ghost said that I want salvation. I want peace. Finally, I want peace because I'm tired of living this life of ghost. So she has gone behind the wall, and ultimately she has gone on her journey towards heaven as well as hell, and has drove away all the terrorizing figures that she has encountered. It means again, that was what? That was her selfless love for ghost. Okay, she wanted. she has gone through that, you can say, terrorizing ways in order to get peace for ghost. Finally, the ghost was buried and he was relieved from this cycle of ghostly time. Okay, and this is all. And finally, she had what kind of peace? That is most beautifully explained in the chapter. Last chapter, you will read, most beautifully explained that she was sitting near the grave of where the ghost was buried, and ultimately beautiful flowers were, you can say, blossomed around her, and she was sitting with her lover, and finally they are going to get married. And he asked that, tell me what you have felt for the ghost and how you get the ghost, how you get salvation for the ghost. She said, no, I won't explain this to you because this is just a thing between me and the ghost. Very beautiful story, of course it is. And yes, coming up to Selfish Giant. Yes, I was talking about Selfish Giant, that you must have heard a garden where the giant was not allowing anybody to enter. Now you got. That is the story of Selfish Giant, okay? So if you want to read, you can have it in the class, I think, 8th or 7th. It is there. Now this year, syllabus, it is there. So that the giant, he was not allowing any child to enter his garden. So in his entire garden, there was frost, cold weather, north wind was blowing strongly, hailstorm. They were tapping with strong force onto the roofs of his house. And giant was very sad that why everywhere there is spring, but in my garden, there is still frost. Silvery layer, it was covering his entire garden. Entire garden means all the leaves. Then leaves were covered with, you can say, with snow. And moreover, there was not any tree blossomed with flowers. No fruit could be seen, but everywhere else it was there. So the giant was very sad. But one day, what has happened? He has seen that one child, few children, they have entered through a hole into his garden. and where the children, every child was sitting on the branches of the tree, some were playing under the trees also. And what happened, the giant has seen that there is, you can say there is a spring in that corner of the garden. So trees were blossomed with beautiful flowers from the earth also, small and colorful flowers. They have taken their heads out. And but in one of the one corner of the garden, at the far end of the garden, there is a young boy who was crying. Okay, and in that tree still there was winter season. Okay, it was covered with frost. The boy was crying to get up to the tree, but because he was too young, too small to move upward, he was not. So the giant went near the boy and he put the young boy onto the tree. And again, that tree blossomed into beautiful flowers. So after a few days, what happened? When the giant was getting ready in front of the mirror, so what he has seen that he heard the cries of the boy. So he thought that who is crying? He looked around the garden. Finally, he found that tree where that young boy was crying. And now this tree, it has turned into golden color. It has turned out to be golden in color, blossomed with white flowers, and you can silvery fruits, they were hanging from it. Means you can say a scene of paradise, heaven. And then he has gone there, the giant has gone there. He asked the boy, why are you crying here? Who has hurt you? He said, you have hurt me. He has shown his hands and as well as his feet on it, the scars of his, you can say, sharp nails were there. Because giant, although he was loving, but he was so harsh at that time, that what happened, that he hurt that child and the child was dead. So ultimately he said, you have to come to me, to my house now along with me. And at that moment, what happened, the giant was found dead under that tree and his entire body was covered with white blossoms. So it was just like that of a beautiful tale, very beautiful story. Okay, so it is actually the writer. Okay, it is the writer who is interested in different type of genres. You can say interested in writing detective stories. For example, the famous writer Arthur Conan Doyle, he's writing detective stories. Sherlock Holmes, you must have heard. Okay. Actually, Sherlock Holmes is not a character any time in living form. It was an imaginary character, you can say, produced by that. It was this imagination. So every person has his own, you can say, type of thinking, and accordingly they are writing. And what I feel is that the writers, they are the most intelligent persons because they are living an abstract life. What it is not there, they are thinking about that thing. And ultimately means they have, you can say, they have magic in their words. When you must have seen that when you are reading this story, the Happy Prince, you are flowing with the words. You are into the story. So this is what? This actually story is how it is, you can say, how it engrosses the reader, how it takes the readers into a flight of, you can say, of imagination. Okay? So one can have a great magic with the words and try to imbibe that kind of magic in your answers also. I don't think so, then anybody can stop you taking marks. Right? And be original in your ideas. So next is, how much land does a man require? This I haven't read. I'll try to read, then I'll discuss. Okay, how does a land a man require? Okay, Leo Tolstoy is also a great writer. Okay, I have to discuss otherwise some extra questions. So the time is not allowing. Let me discuss one. How can you say that the Happy Prince really had a golden heart? How can you say that Happy Prince had a golden heart? Yes. So whatever we have discussed throughout the chapter, that he has sacrificed his entire life, he sacrificed his body, he has given the gold, the embellishments that were covering his statue, and ultimately he was also not afraid to give his eyes for the betterment of, or for the food, to drive away the misery from the life of the other people. So it was only his generosity, his selfless love, his kindness that has made him the person with the golden heart. Okay. So that's all for today. Whenever we will get time in the next lecture, we will discuss extra questions when we will have the revision part. Okay. So that's all for today.